Today I'm going to show you how to knit a chain link garland using a circular knitting machine. This is a very simple pattern and easy to customize with different color combinations for various holidays and occasions. If you enjoy this project, you might also like my pattern books, Circular Knitting Machine Patterns Volume 1 and Volume 2, both available now on Amazon. And you can find this pattern and many more in my Etsy shop. You can find the links to both my pattern books and my shop in the description below. In terms of supplies, for this project I'm using an AliExpress Professional 22 needle circular knitting machine, loops and threads impeccable yarn in a variety of colors, a pair of scissors, and a darning needle. This garland could be knit for so many different occasions. Here are some color combination ideas for Christmas, Valentine's Day, Halloween, or you could use school colors or sports team colors. If you make this project, please tag me on social media when you share your work. You can find me at Diana Levine Knits on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, and Pinterest. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to stay up to date when I release my latest tutorials. Let's get started on the garland. Step 1 is knitting the pieces. Cast onto a 22 needle circular knitting machine using scrap yarn. You'll remove the scrap yarn at the end of the project so the color doesn't matter as long as it contrasts well with the main color. Turn the knob until you reach the first needle. Wrap the yarn around the first needle and then weave it back and forth along all the needles until you reach the end of the row. When you approach the first needle again, wrap the yarn behind the needle to its right and place the yarn into the yarn holder. Hold the yarn with your left hand to provide tension and begin knitting by turning the knob on the right. Knit 5 rows in the scrap yarn. When you finish 5 rows, cut a short tail in the scrap yarn and throw it in the middle of the machine to the right of the first needle. Then grab your main color yarn and throw a very long yarn tail in the middle of the machine and place the yarn tail with the scrap yarn tail between the same two needles and place the yarn into the yarn holder. Hold the two yarn tails together close and low as you slowly begin to knit the next row. Pause the knitting after a few stitches to reset your counter back to zero. Knit 60 rows in the main color yarn. Knit slowly for the first few rows to make sure all the stitches are caught, and then you can pick up the speed for the remaining rows. When you finish 60 rows, stop before the first needle. Cut another long yarn tail in the main color yarn and throw it in the middle of the machine. Grab the scrap yarn again and place it between the same two needles as the main color and into the yarn holder. Hold the two tails together close and low as you slowly begin to knit the first row of the scrap yarn cast off. Knit 5 rows in the scrap yarn. When you finish 5 rows, cut the scrap yarn and continue knitting until the work falls off the needles. If the work gets stuck on a couple of needles, just pull them off manually. Pull the work out of the machine and gently stretch out the stitches. Repeat this entire process again for as many links as you'd like to include in your garland. The project shown here features 14 links, so I'll be knitting 14 pieces in total. Step 2 is grafting the ends of the first piece together. To graft the ends together, fold up the two open sides to meet each other. Thread the yarn tail from the bottom side onto a darning needle. Begin with the first stitch on the top right side. Go down through the first stitch and then up through the stitch directly to its left. I'll show you a close-up here of how I'm working through those stitches. Pull the yarn through. Then go back down to the bottom side and thread down through the first stitch on the right and then up through the stitch directly to its left. I'll show you a close-up here of how I'm working those stitches. Pull the yarn through. Next, go back to the top row. This time you'll begin working through the stitch that you exited out of previously. Just like before, go down through that stitch and then up through the stitch directly to its left. I'll show you a close-up of how I'm working those stitches here. Then go back to the bottom side. Just like on the top side, you'll begin working through the stitch that you exited out of previously. Thread down through that stitch and then up through the stitch directly to its left. I'll show you a close-up of how I'm working those stitches here. Continue in this pattern, alternating between two stitches on the top, followed by two stitches on the bottom, until the end of the row. As you're working, make sure not to pull the yarn too tightly. You're essentially creating a new row of knit stitches, so you want the tension to match the stitches above and below the grafting row. Here you'll see the row of grafted stitches starting to come together, between the scrap yarns. Continue grafting until the end of the row. When you reach the side of the work, flip the piece inside out. My piece is now inside out and I'm ready to finish grafting this side of the piece, working in the exact same process as the other side, alternating between two stitches on the top, followed by two stitches on the bottom. When you reach the last stitch, make sure to thread through every last stitch, and then secure the yarn with one quick knot. We'll finalize the knot later, so just one temporary knot is great. Step 3 is removing the scrap yarn. Next, we need to remove the scrap yarn by unwinding the yarn around and around the work. If it helps, you can roll the yarn into a little ball as you work, or you can cut the yarn every now and then to shorten the tail as you unwind. I just finished removing the scrap yarn from my work. Next, finalize the knot from the two yarn tails to make sure it's secure. If there's a little bump where you began and finished the seam, you can simply rotate the work a few stitches so that the bump is on the inside of the tube. Step 4 is grafting the second piece together. Our first link in the chain is complete. Next, we'll add the second link. Thread the second link through the first link, then follow all the same instructions as earlier to graph the stitches together for the second link and remove the scrap yarn. You now have two links complete. To finish the garland, simply continue in this process for your remaining pieces until the garland is how long you'd like it to be. Quick note, if you prefer not to graft the stitches for this project, you can make the garland without grafting. If you prefer, you can seam the ends closed with a crochet hook and then seam the sides together by hand. It will take a few additional steps, so it'll take a little bit longer, but it will still be beautiful. After you've finished seaming and attaching all your links, your chain link garland is complete. If you enjoyed this pattern, please check out my Knitting Machine pattern books, Circular Knitting Machine Patterns Volume 1 and Volume 2, both available now on Amazon. And you can find this pattern and many more in my Etsy shop linked below. If you make this project, please tag me at Diana Levine Knits on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, and Pinterest. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, comment below, and subscribe to the channel to stay up to date with my latest tutorials.